In this presentation, we are going to talk about PLINK, which is a program, is one of the many programs that allows you to manage data, do analysis, and so on. But it's very good, it's very well established, and this is just an intro to it. So just to start with, you can use the program with a command line window, which is very quick and flexible. But also you can have a look to the graphical version, which is called gPLINK. PLINK can manage also many kind of file formats, but the basic ones are either text files or binary files. We can put most of our data in two files, text files that are called PET and MAP. If we use this style, we will be included in the PET file the IDs and the identification of our individuals together with their phenotypes and genotypes. And the map file will contain the basic columns of chromosomes, SNPs, centimorgan, and base pair, and it will be therefore including the information about the genetic variants, where they are, the location. If we choose to use the binary format, we will be using three files. One of them, the FAM file, will be including the IDs of the people, their sex, their phenotypes. Then the BIM file will be containing the physical position of the genetic markers. And the BED file will contain the IDs again and all the genotypes. Because this is a smaller file, it's more efficient to use. So we usually will be using this kind of format, and we can convert from one to the other. We can also have extra files, like one including the covariates for our analysis. And the way it works is very simple. PLINK just wants instructions from us. So the way we usually do it is just to call the program PLINK and to say, okay, PLINK, I'm giving you this input file. We have to say, okay, which kind of file it is. We have to name it. We are going to do something with it. And there will be a series of flags that we put in between just to say, okay, do this and that. The flags are preceded by these two dashes. We can put modifiers there. We can put a set of multiple instructions. And then we want to give a name to the output file that we want to get. And it's very important to be mindful about the naming of these things, because if we use the same name, it will be rewritten. So just be careful with that. Another thing that is very useful in PLINK is that it creates a log file with all the details of the analysis, what PLINK has read, what has identified in the files, and what has done, and the output. And if there is any error, that will be also reflected there. When using PLINK, we will be all the time consulting the documentation. There is a few websites. I will show you more or less how they look like. But it's something great from this program. It has many instructions and is very nice to use. Let's have a look. So this here is the, let's say, basic PLINK website. As you can see here at the top, there is a note saying that there is more versions available for beta testing. This is the basic website, and it's very nice and neat. Many times, even if you are using other versions of PLINK, you may be consulting the instructions here because, they are complete. It also includes a tutorial, frequent asked questions that are very good. And anyway, you will be usually navigating the menus at the top or here on the left-hand side. Very important, at least for the practical today, we will be checking the data management section and also the association section, because that's the main menu for the GWAS. So yeah, get familiar to it, with it. And here, there's an equivalent website for PLINK 1.9. it looks very similar. You will see in the left-hand side all the, well, the menu with everything that you can think of, input formats, useful flags. One thing that is very nice is that you can just jump to the search box here and just put, just write whatever you need. And then it will take you to the appropriate information. So that's very nice. You will be always checking the file formats because they will tell you what the contents are, what the columns mean specifically. And this is something to have into account because different programs will be giving you different outputs. So, yeah. And yeah, it also includes a list of all the flags that you can think of. The PLINK 2.0 website is similar. You will have, again, here and here. Both include a menu with error messages. And this is it, just an introduction to PLINK.